So final video, maybe I'll make it quick, maybe I won't. We'll see. Religious evolution. I have a friend online, member of the institution, not at all, who, you know, I have people who ask questions and they say, hey, dude, like, for example, how does something like church hopping translate into change in society? I would think everything that I've said so far today should give you a pretty good head start on that. But the reality is that religion is the most tractable, the most authentic. Religion is the vehicle for social change, and there are all kinds of reasons for this. The state is not going to make adjustments for what you want. I'll give you an example about Occupy. When we went and did that at the very beginning, what people were really in need of was a social connection. They were in need of a safe space. They were in need of a landing pad, something that was open and would help them and give them shelter from storms, homelessness, drug abuse, insanity, the police, everyone in this country who has been falling through the cracks, which is literally like half the country right now. You don't even know how many people are living underground around you. You have no clue. And it's an enormous, it's a social problem of epic proportions. It's as bad as a lot of things that are going on in Africa, or, you know, where in the Middle East, or it's easily as bad as anything Russia has, or China too. It's easily, it's like a whole miniature North Korea inside of America, and it's everywhere, and no one can see it. And so people came down into the world and they said, hey, we're gonna post up in the public park and join together and hold hands and sing and try to fucking tie a string around our community. But they didn't want to connect to each other in any kind of legitimate articulation. In fact, there was an enormous resistance to it. So it really doesn't do anything, and only within the actual crowds that started it. For example, there's obviously a Occupy Wall Street crowd in New York that has their work cut out for them. They're doing their thing, but they've got an organizational structure there that's intact, and they've got people who are doing that full time. And the reality is that in Santa Rosa and Sebastopol, you don't have that. You have a resistance toward it. And so, for example, Occupy was not interested in generally, they were not interested. There was a lot of resistance to trying to include churches of any stripe, even if they were liberal, which most of the ones around here are, where I live in Northern California, most of them are, therefore more authentic than others. And so there was just total resistance. They were like, LGBTQT brothers and sisters would be like, fuck churches. I don't want them here after everything they've done. And you try to tell them, hey, like, the churches that we would be going to would already be LGBTQT friendly. And they even have, their ministers are members of that community. And they are just like, no, fuck, I don't believe it. I don't believe it. And it was like, okay. And the bottom line at most meetings where that was brought up seemed to be, no, religion seemed to be kept far. And guess what? They still relied on the churches, and they still do to this day. Even in the post-Occupy expressions that I've seen, they are relying on these places to provide them with space to organize, space to hold meetings, space. Basically, it's usually space, but sometimes it's a logistical coordination of lots of people. And it matters, and I'll tell you right now, the people who are fighting for you in my area right now, they're already a strategic, alliance of spiritual communities in this area that are really, that's what improves life here. It's what makes the weather so cooperative, believe it or not, because the weather doesn't have to be cooperative. It doesn't. And the spirit of the people is upon the earth, and earth feels that spirit. And so if you want to see things change, you have to change the spirit of the people. You have to change people's worldviews. If you want to see people become on, you know, souls on fire, ready for Satyagraha, ready to change their world through peaceful nonviolence, you know, real time, real action, real local solutions, global thinking, all of these things that you really want them to happen, you really want them to manifest and materialize for all of us. We all want to see this community come up. We all want to find ways to constantly remind each other, hey, you know, I learned how to reuse my products like this, or I upcycled this way, or we all need to you know, drive less and carpool more, or let's all share bikes, or let's do whatever it is. Fucking, you know, local horticulture, community gardening projects, everything like that. I'll tell you right now, where I live, Sebastopol, California, one of the things that came up in post-Occupy are things like The Grange and Spiral Foods, which are great ideas. But you know what? Both of these things are like joining a fucking church. My kid's alternative charter school, it's like joining a church. If you want to be part of the Waldorf crowd, it's like joining a church. If you want to be part of one of the hippie drum circles that's happening up on some person's property up in the hills, you got to know somebody who knows somebody and fit in with everybody who's there. So it's already, you know, the religious component, the only way you would say that religions don't evolve is that you haven't studied them, you don't understand them. And if you see how much evolution has happened in the past in this world, you know that religions are behind a ton of it. They're behind almost all of it. And so, for example, I would say people who would say, you know, oh no, you're going to have history that tells you religions didn't do anything, that it was all military powers, and then you're going to blame the military on the religions. And like so many other religions are like, no military. And if even, you know, when have you ever seen a movie about Christopher Columbus where, you know, the general is the compassionate one with the reflexive self-consciousness to know what he's doing is wrong and he needs to shelter the Indians or like build a mission? It's always the priest. The soldiers kill everybody. The priest isn't out there like blood dripping from his mouth, swinging his crucifix around, you know, like sometimes that is the image that's portrayed, but far more often what you see is the guy from the church is always the voice of reason, the voice of moderation. If there is any reason or moderation, it was coming from them at that time. So there are examples galore of how religion has impacted the world for good, how it has led to civil liberties, humanism, equality theory, liberation theory, all of these things, civil rights, did I say that already? Like, the list goes on and on and on. Women's rights. As much as religion has been used to suppress women, it's also been used to liberate women. Women's spirituality movement is a great example. If you don't think that that has a religious organizational structure, you're tripping. There are people who organize these retreats. There are locations where they happen. There are protocols for being there. Money is exchanged. They have 501c3 tax status. It's unbelievable to me that people cannot know what they are talking about and claim to know what they are talking about. Religion is the revolution. It has always been the revolution, the nonviolent revolution through spirituality, through Satyagraha, through the soul on fire, through the belief in an idea, through tying people together through music and common interest and love for one another. That is the most powerful thing that human beings can do to change their world. And when there is not enough of it, the world starts coming apart and turns into a fucking nasty shithole place. And you want to know why the world, you look out into the world, if you don't have your fucking rose goggles on, you cannot help but notice that there is a lot of fucked up shit going on right now. And all of that is created by people who don't have anything better to do. I would say religious revolution and religious evolution are absolutely, absolutely critical unless you want to have a military solution, a final solution. You know what I'm saying? Don't go that route, please. Please, come follow me. Listen to what I'm saying. Join the institution and learn all. Tell your friends about this. Come back. Subscribe to the channel. Join the page. Get to know me. Send me emails. Send me messages. If you can't do any of that and all you have is money, that's the last thing you have to contribute. I don't even have my tax status and everything set up yet, so just sit on it. Please. We need to make this happen. And I mean all you light workers, and I'm going to start focusing on you guys pretty soon too. So beware, light workers who are friends with me, if you made it to the end of this video and you're wondering when I'm going to start addressing some of the crazy fucking paradigms within your bullshit patterns. Ooh, it's going to happen.